नमस्ते, आई एम डॉक्टर राजम, सीनियर कंसल्टेंट एट मिलन फर्टिलिटी एंड बर्थिंग सेंटर कुमारपार्क बैंगलोर। टुडे वी विल बी क्लियरिंग फ्यू मिथ्स अबाउट इन विट्रो फर्टिलाइजेशन ट्रीटमेंट और IVF। इन विट्रो फर्टिलाइजेशन और IVF इज एन इफेक्टिव फर्टिलिटी ट्रीटमेंट विच हेल्प्स कपल अचीव देयर ड्रीम ऑफ हैविंग अ बेबी व्हेन दे आर नॉट एबल टू कंसीव नेचुरली। देयर आर फ्यू मिथ्स अबाउट IVF which discourages the infertile couples from opting for it. Today, we'll be clearing those myths with facts. In vitro fertilization or IVF treatment starts on the day 2 or day 3 of the menstrual cycle. Initially, a scan and few blood tests are done and then injections are started daily for a period of about 7 to 10 days. And serial scans and blood tests are done to monitor the growth of eggs or follicles. When the eggs are ready, egg retrieval is done transvaginally and ultrasound guidance under sedation. The eggs retrieved are given in the embryology lab, which are inseminated with the husband's sperm to form embryos. The resulting embryos are transferred into the mother's uterus to help her get pregnant. And the pregnancy test is done 15 days after the embryo transfer, and supportive medications are given to help her achieve a pregnancy. If they have excess embryos, the excess embryos are frozen and stored for further use. The first bit about infertility treatment or IVF is, infertility is a women's issue and healthy women do not need IVF. Women are always the target of infertility in society and it always takes two to have a baby. The egg is as important as the sperm in creating a conception, and infertility affects men and women equally. So, it is very important to evaluate the husband as well as the wife when they present with infertility. And also, adopting healthy lifestyles like eating healthy food and regularly exercising to maintain a body weight, also avoiding tobacco, smoking, alcohol, junk food, all increases the well-being and general health of the couple. But it is not a replacement for IVF for fertility treatment. It is definitely an adjuvant to increase the success or optimize the IVF treatment. The second myth about infertility treatment or IVF is, infertility treatment or IVF can be done at all ages. The second myth is that infertility or IVF treatment can be done at all ages. It is not so. As a woman becomes older, her fertility reduces, and more so after 35 years. This is because women are born with a limited number of eggs and the egg number reduces as they age, as well as the quality also reduces. So, we all think that as long as a woman is having regular menstrual cycles, she can conceive, and it is not so. The second myth is, infertility treatment or IVF can be done at all ages. It is not so, because fertility reduces as a woman becomes older and more so after 35 years. This is because women are born with a limited number of eggs and the egg number reduces as a woman ages. Also, the quality of the eggs reduces as women become older. So, the success of infertility or IVF treatment also reduces as women become older in age. And also, fertility stops 10 years before a woman reaches her menopause. So getting regular cycle doesn't mean that the woman is fertile. So getting IVF treatment or infertility in the right age is very, very important. IVF treatment is very painful and it requires hospital admission. The treatment of IVF requires daily injections for about a period of a week to 10 days. But these injections are given through a technologically advanced pen, a very thin needle, and they are painless. And also, the retrieval of eggs from the women occurs under sedation transvaginally under ultrasound guidance. The egg retrieval procedure is a daycare procedure and it does not require hospital admission. The whole procedure of IVF may require about 5 to 6 hospital visits and does not require hospital admission. The fourth myth about IVF is, IVF is not safe and I may lose my eggs. This is also not true. IVF is completely safe and it has got no complication. 10 or 15 years back, 0.5% of the couple of the women undergoing IVF may have a complication called ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. And with the advance in technology and science, there are certain methods we follow to avoid this complication. And the incidence of this complication now in fertility clinics is almost nil. So IVF is very safe. And we are born with women are born with a limited number of eggs, that is about 1 to 2 million at birth, and the egg numbers are about 400,000 at menarche. And of these 400,000 eggs, only 400 eggs ovulate in her lifetime. And as we all know, in each menstrual cycle, a woman will ovulate a single egg. And to ovulate this egg, thousands of eggs die or undergo atresia. And IVF rescues these eggs which undergoes atresia or which die in a menstrual cycle. They restore or revive them to be collected and used to make embryos. So in IVF, when undergoing IVF, you are not losing eggs and it does not reduce the number of eggs you have. The fifth myth is fertility medications can cause cancer. And this is also not true, because globally over 50 million couples have undergone IVF till date, and research says that fertility drugs does not cause cancer, and also the medications used in IVF do not have long-term complications. So IVF medications are safe and they do not cause cancer. The next myth is that babies born through IVF are at risk of more birth defects. This is also not true. The process of IVF per se does not increase the risk of birth defects, developmental delay or low birth weight. The risk of birth defects is with natural conceptions also, and the risk with natural conception is the same as the risk with IVF pregnancies. The process of IVF does not increase the risk of birth defects in children, and globally over 8 million children are born through the process of IVF and all are healthy. The next myth is that IVF is 100% successful. This is not true. IVF done in good centers in women less than 35 years yields a success of about 50 to 60%. And the success rate reduces as women become older. Also, the success rate of an IVF depends on many factors like the age of the woman, her egg reserve or quality, the sperm quality, the condition of her uterus and her medical conditions. Globally, the success of an IVF program across all ages is about 35 to 40%. So, without understanding the correct success of an IVF program, often couples get dejected when an IVF fails and try to switch doctors or centers. It is advisable to choose a good center, be prepared to undergo 2 to 3 cycles of IVF or embryo transfer to get a good pregnancy rate. And the doctor who will be treating you will be knowing your history and your medical conditions correctly, so that she will be able to appropriately tell you the next course of treatment in a correct way. IVF causes multiple births and always leads to C-section deliveries. In IVF, there is 10 to 15% risk of having multiple pregnancies or twins. And this is because two embryos are transferred into the woman's uterus to help her get pregnant. And twin pregnancies or multiple pregnancies can be avoided by having a single embryo transfer in younger women. An IVF pregnancy is no different from a natural pregnancy. The need for C-section arises due to obstetric and medical condition, and this can happen with natural conceptions also and not because of IVF. And women undergoing IVF are older with long periods of infertility. So, their babies are considered very precious, and the couples opt to undergo an elective C-section than taking the risk of vaginal birth. So, in IVF pregnancies can have vaginal deliveries if they have no medical or obstetric conditions requiring C-section. The next myth is that all IVF clinics are the same. This is also not true. The quality of IVF clinics vary greatly. The quality of an IVF clinic depends on the team of highly experienced doctors, skilled embryologists, state-of-art IVF lab with latest technologies, transparent ethical counseling, and individualized patient care. We at Milan are a team of highly qualified doctors and embryologists with 30 years legacy and experience in the field of artificial reproductive technology or IVF, with high ethical standards and good and compassionate patient care. Thank you. Do visit Milann Fertility Center if you have an infertility issue. Thank you.